Hey guys, Sean here with Raw Brothers, joined again by my brother Royal, and today we're going to talk about how to fight shorter opponents. A lot of you guys like the taller opponents video, but some of you guys, probably the taller guys, now want to know how to combat that by fighting the shorter guys who actually know how to fight tall guys. So in this video, that's what we're going to cover. Let's get into it. So the first tip for fighting shorter opponents is going to be to fight tall. What a lot of tall guys don't realize is they're not utilizing their height and their reach to their full advantage. So even looking at Royal, if you were to see us fighting right now, you would think that there's not a big difference in height between us. But the reality is, I'm 5'7 and he's 6'1, right? That's a huge difference.
I'm right there. 6'1½. I ain't gonna cut the bait. 6'1½. But 6'2, good thing. Just depends on the shoes, right?
So if you were to look at us boxing each other, you wouldn't be able to tell that there's such a big height difference between us. But the reality is, I'm 5'7 and he's 6'2 on a good day, right? So what we want to do is immediately fix your posture as a taller opponent, right? So what I'll just do with Royal is give him a pointer to just stand up a little straighter. It goes against boxing fundamentals, but you see now he immediately gets a bigger height advantage. So you want to stand up straighter, almost completely straight, and just continue keeping your chin tucked, right? It's okay to keep your chin tucked. But don't be so front foot heavy. Stand up straight, don't curl your back. A lot of tall guys, they fight short. You wanna fight tall and you wanna utilize that height. And now, as a short guy, I'm gonna come in, look at that height difference now. It takes me so much more to reach him, which brings me to my next point, and that is the reach. A lot of fighters, almost all fighters, don't utilize their reach to their full advantage, right? So what a lot of guys do is they'll throw their punch, and they don't realize they have so much more. Because right here, I could still hit him, right? We could still exchange punches, even though he's way taller and he's got way more reach than me, right? But if he just rolls that shoulder out, there's no way I could touch him. And he could just keep me at the end of that jab all night long. And it'll be a long night for me, right? Because it'll be so hard for me to get to him. If I try to come in on the inside, boom, he could clip me, right? So just use that reach to your full advantage. Make sure you're using as much height as you can by sitting up straight and using as much reach as you can to roll that shoulder out. So the next tip is gonna be to use your footwork and not just to escape, right? What a lot of taller guys do is when a shorter guy comes at them, so let's say I'm gonna come at you, he's just gonna go straight back, right? Like I come in on him and a lot of guys just go straight back. That's not really gonna help you all that much. It does create distance, but if I'm a short guy with quick feet like a Lomachenko, I could get on that inside, or like a Mike Tyson, right? If I got those quick feet, I'll be able to get to you pretty fast. Right, so what I want to do here, if I'm the taller guy, is get out of that habit of immediately going back, right? That's the natural reaction. Someone comes at you, you go back. What you want to do with the little guys is turn them to create that distance, right? So if I'm coming at him, what he's going to do is he's going to sidestep and pivot. He's going to constantly turn me to keep me uncomfortable. Not only is this going to get me off balance, but it's also gonna wear me out because I'm constantly having to shift with him, right? So let's go and show an example of it. So here I am coming at him, he's gonna sidestep, boom, and turn me, right? That immediately makes me have to recheck, and now he, as soon as he turns, boom, he could clip me. I'm gonna do that again. Now I'm coming at him, sidestep, boom, turn me. You see that? It's really hard for me. If I'm trying to throw punches, he could just clip me on the way in as he's turning. Again, this is gonna wear me out physically, it's gonna wear me out mentally because I'm constantly chasing a moving target that's not just linear, right? He's always changing, shifting angles on me. Shifting angles is not just for the little guy. If you're the taller opponent, you wanna turn. All right, so for this next tip, basically what you wanna do is not let your opponent bait you. Mike Tyson was a master at this. What he would do is he would create high pressure situations for his opponents where he would close the distance without throwing anything, but because he was so close, the opponent immediately begins to feel fear and react out of fear, so they start throwing. They start throwing shots. But if I'm the little guy, what happens is I can just get off that center line, boom, boom, and now I've baited you. Because with me, I gotta take two steps to get to you, right? I gotta step, and then I gotta punch. Where the taller guy, all he has to do is punch as I step, right? It's only one motion. So if I'm the shorter guy, I'm gonna bait this guy into throwing, and if you're the taller guy, you don't wanna be baited. What you gotta do is if I'm pressuring you, just turn me and reset. Right, you want to reset constantly. You don't want to just start getting into a firefight. As soon as the smaller guy is in punching range, you need to get out of there. You don't want to have that firefight with the shorter guy because you're going to be on the losing end. When he's at full range, you're at half range. So the punches you guys are exchanging are not equal. So you want to make sure that you don't let them bait you into throwing shots by creating those high pressure situations. If I'm creating a high pressure situation, he's gonna use his feet to get out of there. He could even do things like put his hand on my head and just kind of push me out of the way as he turns, right? And maybe clip me on the way out. Don't let the little guys bait you into a firefight. So the next tip is gonna be to make the shorter guy pay when they get him on the inside, right? It's gonna be pretty easy for you guys to see when the shorter guy's trying to pressure you, trying to close that gap. What you wanna do is never allow that gap to close and then make them pay for it when they try to. Make them hesitate. If you make them pay and you hurt them, they're gonna hesitate to come in, and from there, it's your fight all night long, right? And the way you wanna do that is by sticking behind your jab. So as soon as I try to close that distance, so let's say he extends his arm all the way, he should never let me get beyond this reach, because here, I can never reach him, right? So as soon as I start closing enough distance to where I'm inside this reach, what he wants to do is make me pay for it or get out of there, right? Or both. So what we're gonna do is, as soon as I try to come in, boom, shoot the jab right at me, right? And just keep turning me with the jab, right? Combining all the tips, keep me at the end of that reach. It's almost like you wanna feel like there's an opposing magnet between you that's trying to repel you guys, right? So what you wanna do is constantly keep that same distance. So as soon as I come in, boom, fight behind that jab. As soon as I come in, boom, fight behind that jab. Turn me, and then just clip me with the right hand, right? Hit me, if I'm coming in this way, clip me with that right hook, boom. Right, because if I'm turning an angle this way, I'm walking into that right hand. Right, if I'm walking this way, clip me with that left hook. Right, boom. Make me walk into those shots. Every time I choose an angle this way, hit me this way. Every time I come this way, hit me with that right hand. And constantly use your feet, turn them, and make them pay. The most important thing is to make your opponent pay when they try to close that distance. And then from there, they're going to be a little more wary about coming in because they don't want to get knocked out, right? So now, it's your fight to just keep me here and keep me at the end of your jab and pick me apart. It's what Vladimir Klitschko used to do beautifully. It's what guys like Tyson Fury do beautifully. Keep your opponent at the end of that jab, keep that range going, turn them, and then clip them with the power shots. And once you get them to hesitate, what you want to do is, I don't know,
what do you want to do? Oh, shit. Wait, what do I want to do? Quick break. A word from our sponsor.
And guys, as soon as you get them to hesitate, what you want to do is start pressuring them. Don't just play the baiting game the whole night and fight off your back foot, right? As a taller opponent, it's okay to walk forward as long as you're keeping them at that distance, at your distance, right? So as soon as you start sensing that hesitation, pressure them. Start walking them down, right? Because that mental pressure is going to get to them, right? Keep them at the end of your reach. Right, Rory was afraid to hit me, but if he actually extends, boom, he could get me on my back foot. And as the taller opponent, if you get me on my back foot, the fight is yours, because then you're getting to control that range. Right, you're getting to control that range. So make sure once you get them to hesitate, you can start walking them down and finish the fight. You don't have to just try to win the decision and win off the fight. Try to end it, right? Be a fighter, end that fight, pressure them, break them down physically and mentally. So the next tip is gonna be to shoot when they shoot when they're out of range. A lot of time what shorter guys will do is they'll try to shoot punches just to test the range. But as soon as you see that, don't wait on them. Don't let them feel you out. You're in range, right? So shoot. As soon as you're in range, shoot. And look, if you keep me at a distance, I can't find my range. I'm constantly gonna be looking out for his shots, right? So stay busy. You constantly want to stay busy. If I'm the shorter guy and I'm trying to test my range, you want to shoot those punches, shoot that right, shoot those hooks, right? You want to not let me settle in to finding my range and finding my distance. You want me to stay confused and you want to just stick me with those shots and make me regret even being in the ring that night. The next and last tip is going to be to not fight on the inside. If you're the taller opponent, there's no reason to go into a battlefield where you don't have the advantage, right? Why would you give up an advantage? There's nothing to prove other than winning the fight and knocking your opponent out. So don't get into a position where that's gonna be harder to beat, right? When I get on the inside, like we talked about, I'm a shorter guy, I've got more power, right? I've got more power. Now, one thing that Roy hasn't had to do is still fight short, right? So even on the inside, you wanna fight tall, right? You wanna strain that back out, boom. And you still wanna make it harder for me to reach, because that shoulder, it's gonna be harder to turn over for the hooks. Right here, I get perfect leverage. Here, it's much harder for me to hit harder, right? So, even on the inside, you wanna fight tall, but you don't wanna fight on the inside, right? But when you do find yourself on the inside, keep yourself tall, and what you wanna do is get out of there, right? You want to get out of the inside, but you also want to make them pay for it. This way they don't think about doing it again, right? They might think twice before they try to get on the inside again. And here's how you do that. There's going to be two things that you want to do. One is you want to position one of your feet on the outside. This way you could turn your opponent, right? You'll be able to turn out of there. So if I'm fighting here and we're looking at our feet, you want to step on the outside of your opponent. And you can do this kind of really subtle. You don't have to make it obvious, right? Just as you're in there and you're blocking shots, put that foot on the outside. And then the next thing you want to do is put your gloves on top of their gloves, right? So if we're fighting on the inside, you want to put your gloves on top of my gloves. And then as you go to turn me, you push that glove down and shoot the shot, right? You want to make sure, because this will do two things, right? Having your hand over your opponent's gloves will do two things. One is it can help you push it down and clip them on the way out as you turn them. But another thing is it'll help you know which shots are coming, and it'll help them prevent throwing the shot as you turn. So the only shot that they'll really have as you're going to turn out is the shot that's going in the direction you're going, which will be uncomfortable for them to throw. They won't be able to get a lot of momentum because they're just going in the same direction you're going. So if he throws that left hook, I'm turning out. And then he leaves himself open, right? Because I kept this hand at bay the whole time. So whichever direction you want to go in, that's the direction you want to step outside of. So let's say Royal's going this way, he's going to pivot off that foot. Boom, he's stepping there, and he's keeping his glove on top of mine to push me down. So turn, push, and then shoot that shot. If you do that, you'll make them regret coming on the inside. It's not something they're going to want to do. And you constantly just want to take things away from your opponent. You want to look at the fight, and you want to think about, what is this guy trying to accomplish? And once you start finding those things out, take them away. Constantly take them away. And once you take away one of his game plans, then you take another one of his game plans away, they're going to start to panic. And once they start to panic, the fight is yours for the taking. That's when you go for the kill. The best way to get better at fighting shorter guys is to practice fighting shorter guys, right? If you're the taller opponent, it's probably not difficult for you to find a shorter sparring partner. So make sure you focus on these little techniques when you're sparring. Again, don't focus on winning the sparring match. Focus on getting better in the sparring match to win the actual fights. So in sparring, pick a goal in mind, right? Today you're gonna work on turning. Today you're gonna work on keeping them off your jab. Today you're gonna work on fighting tall, right? Like we seen Royal, even after the first tip and a couple of shots later, he went back down to habits. So you're gonna have to work to break out of those habits a little bit, to get used to fighting tall, right? And know how to change that at the drop of a dime. Because sometimes you may fight a guy that's bigger than you, so you may need to go on the inside and get some of that leverage, right? So you gotta learn how to switch it up. You gotta learn how to do everything good in that ring. The only way you're gonna do that is by isolating certain things in practice and getting better at them. Let me know in the comment section below what you guys thought about the video and which one of these tips resonated with you the most. Also, don't forget to follow Royal on Instagram. He's about to launch his own YouTube channel. He's got a ton of inspiration on there to help you guys get fit, help you guys get big. This muscle will definitely help you in the fight. It's what I call an equalizer. When you have that power, it makes the fight a lot more even if the guy is even a little better than you, right? That power is very much an equalizer. Also, don't forget to check out the fight store. There's a ton of gear for you guys there, posters, all kind of inspirational stuff. Put on the shirt, let everybody know that you're a badass and they really should mess with you. Other than that, I'm Sean Brawl Brothers. This is Roy Georges, and we'll ball with you guys next time.